Hi, I'm Corey Ryan Earle, class of 2007, and today we're going to talk about time capsules. And today we're actually going to open up one of those time capsules that was a cornerstone for Thurston Hall. I'm really excited to see what we find inside, so follow me. Hi, I'm Corey Earle, Cornell's unofficial historian, and I'm here with Dean Archer and the Cornerstone Box for Thurston Hall. And this is a box that was placed in the cornerstone of the building when it was being built. 1952 was when this box was placed in the building, and we're going to open it up and find out what's inside. A cornerstone is usually the stone on the corner of the building with the year on it, often that says, you know, 1952 or whatever year it is. And this is probably one of the last formal cornerstones that I know of on Cornell's campus. Should we dig in?
Well, let's dig in, let's cut in, yeah, let's figure out what's in there.
Oh, wow. It's the 100th anniversary of the birth of Robert Thurston.
So it was an event held on campus in the 1939. And right here we have a copy of the Cornell Widow. And the Cornell Widow was the campus humor magazine, a student-run publication of jokes and humor of the time. 1895, A History of the Growth of the Steam Engine by Robert Henry Thurston.
Something that caught my attention, actually, you applied soils engineering, right? So at the present time, we talk about developing stronger bridges between engineering and the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. Well,
it's a great example.
Yeah,
right.
They were already here, right? Some 60, 70 years ago.
And that's long been part of what makes Cornell special, is this breadth of fields of study taught here and that interdisciplinary, collaborative nature of Cornell. Right, here's a copy of the Cornell Alumni News. And this is a December 1951 issue, but the cover story is Dean Dexter Kimball of the Engineering College sitting for his portrait, which will be hung in Kimball Hall. So this is the campus development plan from June of 1951. Here's the engineering quad down here. And so they've proposed site for electrical engineering. They're pointing out where Phillips Hall, where we're standing right now.
Yeah.
They're recommending that we tear down some of the faculty cottages that were there at the time. Here's Ithaca Journal. And it looks like we have a copy of the New York Times as well from April 23rd, 1952. A Cornell Daily Sun from April 21st, 1952. So the more local news. A booklet on engineering at Cornell.
At Cornell, the engineering student has available all the resources of this great university. Sounds familiar?
That's one of the.
I just said that this morning.
Yeah. Part of what makes Cornell special, yeah. And it looks like the last document is a copy of The Cornell Engineer, which was a publication, a student-run publication in the College of Engineering.
Fifth-year projects, right?
Yeah, College of Engineering used to be a five-year program. And so what we'll do with all these materials now is we'll want to preserve them so in 100 years we'll still be able to look back and see what they thought was important to tell the story of Cornell Engineering in 1952. And so these will go to the university archives, which are held in Kroc Library. They have a couple of other of the cornerstone contents that have been opened over the years. I think the goal with a cornerstone is to capture that snapshot of a time in Cornell's history. And so you can tell they tried to look at national news, local news, the student experience, who were the people at Cornell at the time, and then some information about the namesake. So a lot of material about Thurston himself so that we can remember, you know, why did we put Thurston's name on this building? What was his impact and influence?
So what struck me actually as I was thinking about how to open the box is the stuff that came out first. It was really sort of personal, Thurston, but then it sort of went outwards, right? We saw the national news, what's going on at the time, and the student experience. And that I think is really quite powerful, you know, the volume of information that you capture about the man, the context, and the future in the collection. So this is pretty well done.
Well, thank you for joining me for this.
Well, thank you, Corey. This is extremely informative. Thank you.